So it's unclear what the new normal will look like, but clearly it'll look different than everyone working from home. So when people start to come back to the office, what will meetings look like? That's what I want to talk about in this video. Surely some people will still be working at home and some people will be working in the office. So how do you combine them together in a meeting? I'm Brighton West and I work with coaches, mostly lots of executive coaches, and their clients are heading back to the office. But if you are a coach, please click the subscribe button and the little bell icon down below to receive future videos. I am still working from home, and of course I'm joined by my cat Tiger. So in this video, I'm gonna talk specifically about three different kind of technical setups of how you can set up your meetings to be kind of half on Zoom and half in real life. I've got another video that you're gonna be able to find up here about some of the best practices. So really this is a two-part video series, and I'll have a link at the end of this to watch the best practices too. So one way you could set up your office for these half in and half out meetings is to get a big screen TV to add to your conference room, and then hook that up to your laptop. And so the Zoom participants are shown on a screen in the conference room while everyone else is sitting there locally. The problem here is that we're really starting to designate those Zoom people as being separate, and it's hard for them to participate fully in the meeting when everyone else is sitting there talking to each other. These folks are kind of in the background. Even worse is if you just have a laptop screen set up that shows the Zoom participants, because now they're really tiny and having a hard time participating. So that is an option, but not necessarily the best. Another option is just to make everyone equal and have those people who are in the office join the meeting from their desk. Everyone's gotten very used to Zoom meetings and just being on camera in their home office. So if they're at their desk, is that really that bad? You don't get that connection that you have in the physical meeting. And I think there's definitely some benefits to that. And in that second video, I'm gonna talk a little bit about that. But it is an option to just have everyone join as if they were alone as Zoom participants. Another way to do this is to have each of the participants who are in the meeting together have their own laptop in front of them. And I feel like this is the most equitable way to do it, because you've got people who are together participating, but they're showing up exactly the same to those who are on Zoom. So if Bob is talking, everyone can look at Bob, but also those people on camera have a view directly of Bob instead of a view from a laptop at the end of the table where it's viewing the entire room. So those who are participating remotely are just seeing a tiny little Bob in the back corner of the room. And of course, you can combine these two. So one of the best things might be to combine the laptops together in the room with the TV on the end. Also, I think the best thing to do with those laptops is to put them up on some boxes or books so that everyone looks good. So the laptops are a little higher and a little closer to eye level, so the people online aren't being looked down upon. And this setup allows each person in the room to look at the individuals on Zoom straight ahead of them. And the same thing vice versa. The people on Zoom are seeing each person individually. So if everyone's in the same room on a bunch of different laptops, you'll want to make sure that all except for one have mute on and also the volume turned down, or you'll be hearing it slightly delayed across a bunch of different computers, and that'll cause that feedback. So I think it's very important to work on this idea of equality, because people have a lot to contribute whether they're in the room or they're at home working from home. And sometimes there's a pretty big barrier for those who are either on an audio conference or a video conference compared to those who are together in the room. So there are some wonderful best practices, and I've put together a video specifically about that. So you can click up here to watch the video on the best practices for Zoom, mixed Zoom, and in real life meetings. I'll see you over in that video.